In this video, you will learn about bag of words using the count vectorizer. We will import the count vectorizer from sklearn, from sklearn.feature_extraction.text import class count vectorizer. Let's execute our code. Let's create a Python list of sentences and convert it into numeric form using the count vectorizer. I'll make one variable train_text. I'll make a Python list, and inside this I will save four sentences. I have copied four sentences. I'll paste it, and these are the four sentences. You can put any sentence here. Let's execute our code. Just to save the time, I have already copied these four sentences and I have pasted it here. Let's execute our code. Let's print our variable train text. Print train text. In the output, we can see we have a Python list, and inside this we are having four sentences. Let's instantiate the count vectorizer object. I'll make one variable count vectorizer, or just vectorizer. Next, I will call the class count vectorizer. Let's execute our code. Next, let's call the fit method and pass in the variable train text. I will call the object vectorizer, and then from this object I will call the property fit, and I'm going to fit it on train text. Let's execute our code. The fit function will pre-process all of the sentences we pass in. It will convert all these words into lowercase and generate a tokens of words. Let's get the feature names the count vectorizer has extracted from your text. Let's call this vectorizer, and from this we will call the property get feature names. You can see that all the words have been lowercased, and these are the feature names which have been extracted from the four sentences present in this variable train_text. The vocabulary property on the vectorizer object will give you all of the words that the vectorizer can present. I'll call our object vectorizer, and then I will call the property vocabulary_. Let's execute our code. In the output, you can see we got the vocabularies, and these are the associated unique IDs. Since there are total 9 vocabularies, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, we got the 9 unique numbers starting from 0 ending at 8. The vocabulary here is a dictionary that maps every word in your input text on which the vectorizer has been trained to a unique integer ID. This numeric ID is used to represent a particular word in your text. You can use the get function on the vectorizer to access the numeric ID associated with a particular word. For example, we want to get the numeric ID of the Word document. We can get it. I'll call the object vectorizer, and then I will call vocabulary_. Then I will call the property get, and I want to get the numeric ID of the Word document. I'll copy this code from here. I'll copy this word from here, paste it here. Let's execute our code, and you can see we got the numeric ID of our Word document, and here also it is 1, here also it is 1. Next, we will convert our sentences saved in the variable train_text into bag of words representation by calling the transform function of the count vectorizer. I'll make one variable transform_vector. Now I will call the object vectorizer. From this I will call the property transform, and I'll pass our variable train_text. Let's execute our code. Let's check the shape of this variable transform_vector.shape. The result is a transform vector of numeric representation, and the shape of this vector is 4 by 9 because we are having four sentences and nine vocabulary. Here you will see we have four sentences, 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's why we got 4 here and 9 here, because we are having 9 vocabulary, and this vocabulary are the features 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So we got 4 by 9. You can also understand it as rows and columns. We have 4 rows and 9 columns, where rows are our sentences and columns are the vocabulary or the feature names. Let's call toArray function to see what the bag of representation looks like. I will call our variable transformed vector, and then I will call toArray. Let's execute our code. The count vectorizer gives us a frequency based representation of words in our input text, and these are the features here. A frequency of 1 is associated with every word in the sentence. If a word occurs twice, we will get 2 here, and if the word is not found, we will get 0 here. Let's test it on a new text. I'll make one variable, test underscore text. I'll make a Python list and I'll write a sentence: I am learning NLP. Let's execute our code. Let's print our variable test underscore text. In the output, you can see we have one sentence here: I am learning NLP. If these words are not found in the vocabulary of our count vectorizer, we will get 0 at all places, because during fitting the count vector, this sentence was not present. If any word is found in the vocabulary, we will get 1 or its frequency. Let's transform this. We will call our vectorizer object. Then I will call the property transform, and I'll pass our test underscore text and convert it to toArray. Let's execute our code. And here you will see we got 00 here, because let's look at the vocabulary or the feature names. Both feature names and vocabulary are same. All these words are similar. There are no difference. I'll paste it here. And these are the feature names. If you compare this sentence with the feature names, do you see I is present in our feature names? No. So we got 0 here. Is am present? Am is also not present. We got 0 here. Learning is present. Learning is also not present. We got 0 here. NLP is present. NLP is also not present here. So we got 0 here. And rest, all these zeros are for to make it 9 words, because in our vocabulary we are having 9 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. That's why we got 9 0 here. In actual, we are having only 4 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. But since our vocabulary has 9 words, to fill those 5 words, we are putting 5 extra 0 here, and that is why we got 9 zeros here. To overcome this problem, we can do one thing. We can call the fit method on the test data along with the train text. I'll call the object vectorizer, and then I will call the property fit, and this time I'm going to fit on both train and text. Train text plus test underscore text. Let's execute our code. Let's look at the vocabulary to find the new words from the variable this test underscore text. I will call this object vectorizer, and from this I will call the property vocabulary. And here you will see we have 9 vocabularies starting from 0 to 8. Let's execute our code and see we will get new vocabulary, because we have added this test underscore text variable. Let's execute our code. Now our vocabulary has increased. Now we have new words such as NLP learning app. Let's now transform our test underscore text. I'll call this vectorizer. Then from this transform test underscore text and also convert it to array. Let's execute our code. In the output, you can see now we got 1 and 0. Earlier, we were getting only 0 here. And we got 1. This video was about bag of words representation using count vectorizer. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.